Because my mom is loving and caring.
My mom is the best because she loves me and is willing to do anything for me.
She's caring and she thinks for other people, not just herself.
I think my mom is the best because she's always supportive. She lives a really, really busy life. Yet she makes time for me and my brother. They're spending some quality family time. My mom's always makes herself available in those times.
My mom is a lot of things, but I think she's the best because she's my number one fan. Don't you think?
Of course.
My mom's the best because she's not just a mom, but a comedian, a stylist, a master chef, an excellent baker, an entrepreneur, a model, a shoulder to cry on.
My mom is the best because she is very kind, down to earth, understanding and generous.
My mom is the best because she is really caring, loving, and very hardworking.
My mom is the best because of three things. Number one, she's hardworking. Number two, she's caring. And number three, she's gracious.
My mom is the best in my opinion because she's so understanding. Whenever I have a problem, I'm able to talk to her and she's able to bring back joy to me.
Many reasons make her the best, but one thing that stands out is really her ability to be omnipresent no matter where in the world she is.
My mom is the best because she's very patient and approachable and she can cook amazing food.
My mom is the best because she's usually the life of the party. She's the one who gets everyone going.
As a mother, she's very worrisome and with that comes with her caring about our needs all the time.
Appreciate that she is always looking for the good people and tries to give as many compliments as possible.
Because she loves me so much.
She loves being with me and the rest of the family.
I appreciate the fact that when she wants something, she really goes for it. Whether it be in the restaurant business or anything particular, she always finds the best effort to make sure that thing pushes through.
My mom taught us to drop everything for family, and I think that influenced everyone. And family times are always the best, all the time.
She knows what to say. She has a great taste in music, in planning for our family travels, and fashion, obviously.
What I love and appreciate most about my mom is that she's always making sure we stay healthy and we have a good lifestyle.
What I love and appreciate most about my mom is her ability be patient and understanding to others. She knows how to make others feel better.
She's always there for you, no matter what, and she's not afraid to give out her personal opinion on topics. And she also is looking for what's best for others and not for herself.
Whenever I'm happy or I just want to talk about anything, she'll listen. Even if it's something like video games and she doesn't understand it, she'll listen to me.
Well, like, even when I'm talking about the stupidest thing, I feel like I can talk to my mom and she'll nod along. She might not understand whatever's going on, but she'll nod, and sometimes that's all you need.
She's always able to show her concern for all her children, all my siblings. Imagine 7 of us kids growing up at the same time. And she was always able to split herself into 7 equal parts, giving all of us pretty much equal attention.
What I appreciate most about my mom is how she makes us feel so loved, no matter how busy she gets.
Whatever situation we are in, she will always be in the best mood, fill the whole room with laughter, and of course, have the biggest smile among everyone.
Well, by now you know that my mom's all about family, so she told me once that invest in your family and you'll be rewarded with great foundations and a good backup system.
Don't you agree?
I agree.
You should never hesitate to give to people who are less fortunate than you.
To be good to other people and don't give up.
That to give thanks to God and give back to other people.
I want something, exert so much effort, exert all your effort into that thing you're passionate about, and so far, that's the best piece of advice you've given me, because everything I personally want to achieve, any of my goals, I was able to accomplish it with that piece of advice that she's given me.
Well, my mom's the only one who can truly be honest with me when I turn to her for advice. She knows what's best for me, and isn't that what St. Thomas Aquinas says about love? to will the good of the others, not just in thoughts, but in actions and words.
The best piece of advice that my mom has given me is probably to always be kind to others, but don't let others step over you.
The best piece of advice my mom has ever given to me is to love yourself and never compare yourself to others.
Every time you pray, you're talking to God and God is listening. And it's up to Him. It's His will if He wants something to happen to you. And it's always for the best.
The best piece of advice she's ever given me is to be myself, because she's always wanted me to be myself and not other people.
And when I remember my mom telling me, like, the night before I took my ACT, that you've been studying for this for what, 3-4 months now? You are good enough for this. And I think that's just always so key. Because if you never believe you're good enough for anything, how will you ever actually be good enough for anything?
The best piece of advice that has stuck, I would say, would have to be, don't leave till tomorrow. Anything that you can do today.
The best piece of advice she's ever given me is put God at the center of your life, no matter what.
What my mom puts emphasis on is to make the most of our youth, because it's something that we can't relive again.
Another advice she's given me is to always stand up for myself.
If I could take my mom anywhere, it would probably be the Bahamas, because it's really beautiful like her.
If I could take my mom somewhere, I would take her to London.
I would take her to a beautiful beach where she'll be able to relax and disconnect from all the world's worries.
I would take her to South Africa so we can see the lovely animals again.
I would take her to Finland to see the northern lights again.
I'd probably take my family to Paris. Our family loves to eat. Every time we travel, we just eat at different places, and French cuisine is something my mom made me and my brother experience at a very young age, which we're really, really thankful about.
I think for us, it's always been just family time. Anywhere we are, whatever we're doing, just as long as we're together, preferably over good food and wine, and with the perfect weather, always the best time.
The Cherry Blossom Festival in DC for sure. We were supposed to go in Holy Week, and I was supposed to have the honor of driving my mom around to see all the hidden gems in DC and all that the US Capitol has to offer. And take her Instagram photos, of course.
I want to make my mom happy. And the parlor is the number one place. Once she's in that parlor, it's a good day. Well, she's been to this place before, but she really loves it there. She loves the city, she loves the people and the food, France.
It would be the Royal Ascot in the UK.
Marrakesh, because it's her dream destination.
If I were to take my mom to a place, it would be LA in the winter season. Because of the food, the weather, and most importantly, shopping. And with that, she gets to treat me whatever I want.
Thank you for being so kind to me, and I hope I will be able to help you in times of stress. Just like how you're helping your mom during this pandemic.
Mommy, I love you and you're the kindest person I know. Happy Mother's Day. I love you, Mommy.
Thank you for being caring to us and loving us more than anything. You're the best mom in the whole wide world.
I love you, Mom. Happy Mother's Day. Let's pray. Let's pray together that everyone, your workers, this family will get through this pandemic together. And I also pray that we both stay safe and this family stay safe. Happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there, and stay safe and healthy.
Happy Mother's Day from your two mama's boys. We love you. See you at the kitchen or the dining table.
Hi Mom, this is truly your day no matter where we are or what's going on in the world right now. I don't know what I'd do or who I'd be without your love, your support, your guidance, and all the sacrifices you and Dad made for me, Micah, and Anya. And here's a little quick tune for when you're washing your hands. Happy Mother's Day!
My message to you this Mother's Day, Mama, is that I hope you stay healthy and that you may continue to fill us with your joy and love. Love you, Mama.
Mom, I hope that you'll always stay safe and that you'll always stay healthy. I hope that you may continue to brighten our lives and that others can do the same for you. I love you very much, Mama.
Hey Mom, it's Kuya. Happy Mother's Day. May God continue to bless you. And I'm so glad that we're spending more time with each other here at home. Happy Mother's Day.
Please just know that we're always there for you, so don't be afraid to ask for help. To ask for help, because we're here to support you as well as much as you support us. But also, next time, please be the one to cut my hair.
I know during this quarantine period, it's kind of like depressing, sad, whatever. And all I'd like to tell her is I'll always be okay because your family's with you. And I think that's the key thing that I want to tell her. So, love you, Mom. Happy Mother's Day, Mom. I'm the best child.
He's lying.
No.
Although we've spent many Mother's Days apart by a long distance, this one is very different. So my only message to you on this Mother's Day is for your safety and well-being. Happy Mother's Day, Mom. I miss you, I love you, and I'll see you soon.
Happy Mother's Day, Mom. Thank you for everything you have given us. You really are my superwoman.
Happy Mother's Day to all the lovely mothers out there, and have a wonderful day.
Happy Mother's Day, Mom.
We love you.